Welch experience was another turning point, because the interesting thing is I had met my second wife, Winnie, while I was an undergraduate at Columbia. And when I went to work at Welch Medical Library, took that job in 51, she said, this is a, she made up her mind, this is a decision point, either way, I go to Baltimore with you or we're finished. So we decided she would stay, and I went to Baltimore. And Stefan was living with my sister. I had gotten, my mother gave me a present for graduating, which was a lot of money in those days. I gave the money to my sister to take care of Stefan. So I went to Welch, and at that project, I started out, it turned out, Sam Larkey was a very, a frustrated alcoholic, if I could put it that way. And a medical degree, and also a degree in literature from Oxford. And sort of allegedly a medical historian, okay? So how he fell into the job as director of the medical library, I do not know, but he did. And I spent the next 2 years working for him on that project. And essentially, each day consisted of the two of us sitting across the table. It was located in one wing of the library, Welch Medical Library, and discussing, he would tell me all his war experiences as a medical, I don't know what he did in the Army. And we discussed subject heading analysis in terms that, you know, we're going to be put into the subject heading authority list. That was 9 to 5. At 5 o'clock, he would go home, and he and his wife had a big social life, and she was a member of the Democratic National Committee. In the evenings, when I started to do the research, okay, and that was where I got to know the people at the Army Medical Library, and became the Armed Forces Medical Library. And later, after I had left, it became the National Library of Medicine. And then I got to know Seymour Taine and Bob Hayne. Through Bob Hayne was the subject heading authority editor, more or less. And you know, Bob came to work for me later, much later. I met all sorts of leading librarians and scientists at that project. Met Estelle Brodman was at the National Library. Dave Kronick was there. These were where I met all these people. And you know, you meet enough bright people, you learn quite a bit from meeting such a group. And on top of which, the Welch Medical Library Indexing Project had an advisory committee of about 15 honorary consultants. Apparently, serving on such a committee is, as some people like to do this, because you know, they get to go to a meeting once every 3 or 4 months, and they get their expenses paid, and they get to meet other interesting people. You know, it's like we have an advisory committee here, and you, why would somebody do that? Because it wasn't a financially rewarding thing, it was an intellectually rewarding thing. And that committee consisted of a lot of incredibly bright people. Mortimer Taube was on that committee. Chauncey D Leake was the chairman. And that's how Chauncey and I became very good friends, and he became a kind of mentor to me. And Verner Clapp, the Chief Assistant Librarian of Congress, was on the committee. Eugene Scott. It's all recorded.